Along comes an unknown patch of land. You gaze over it and you say, I will name this land Narnia, with its capital, Winterfell. Let's learn the fun size story of the New World's fictional place names. San Salvador, the first European place name in the Americas. Named for the Lord and Savior that would soon be forced down its residents' throats. This exotic land, assumed to be somewhere in Indonesia, inspired Columbus and his sailors with wonderment. Since it was also assumed to be full of fragrant and valuable spices, it also excited immeasurable greed. All Europe, except for Columbus, soon understood that these lands were part of an entirely new and unknown continent, populated with new and unknown humans. And with conquest came new place names. Naming a territory after a saint symbolically claimed the land for the Catholic faith, while naming it after one's royal benefactors honored the people that paid you. Columbus's name for today's Cuba was Juana, after Queen Isabella's son. Native place names, San Salvador's was Guanani, were also recorded to be used as later proof that an explorer had been there first, if any interloper should decide to try to claim the land for another country. But sometimes, these places were named after mythical lands found in popular fiction. You see, the printing press had also just been invented. Books could now be pumped out by the hundreds, and entrepreneurial authors wrote captivating stories to sell their work at scale. And the most popular genre of the day was the chivalric romance. Stories of fictional knights like Amadis of Gaul, who traveled to distant lands and fought monsters. So popular that they inspired a moral panic, with authorities considering banning the literature. A main concern was that people would believe everything they read in print. Similar to how you have to yell at Nana that the memes on her Facebook group aren't the actual news. This panic didn't stop the Holy Roman Emperor, Charles V, many of the explorers of the New World, and even Saint Ignatius and Saint Teresa from voraciously consuming these stories. Now, while your average conquistador was likely the sneakiest, low-down, dirty opportunist that history has ever known, every group of miscreants has a romantic. So just as vast, new, and wondrous lands were being discovered, these fantastical stories were being written, and they served to recruit new generations of young men, inspired to go on a quest for riches and fame like their fictional heroes. Bernal Diaz de Castillo, part of the party that first laid eyes on the Aztec capital, Tenochtitlan, referenced the aforementioned Amadis when he described what he saw. We could not help remarking to each other that all these buildings resembled the fairy castles we read of in Amadis of Gaul. All across the Americas, you can find place names derived from the chivalric romances. Olinda, a city in Brazil, was possibly named after the cousin of Amadis. The region of Patagonia was named after Patagon, a character from the series Palmerín de Oliva. The famous novel, Don Quixote, which was actually a satire poking fun at these frivolous stories and the idiots who followed them, ironically inspired the name of Barataria Bay, Louisiana, named after the island governed by Quixote's sidekick, Sancho Panza. Even the name Brazil may originate from legend. The official story is that it comes from a type of wood harvested in the area, but medieval maps show a mythical island off the coast of Ireland or Africa named High Brazil or just Brazil. That would be some freaking coincidence. A final legend which inspired an almost pathological fixation was the land of the woman warriors known as the Amazons. Many conquistadors expected to find this land right around the next corner. And some, like Hernan Cortes on his way to Mexico, was officially ordered to search for them. To be fair, a variety of native peoples across the Americas swore they existed. But this was likely because the Spanish kept asking about the Amazons. And no doubt, They would say anything just to get these threatening folks to move along faster. Amazons also appear in the chivalric literature, and hence inspired place names. In Las Sergas de Esplandian, a sequel to Amadis of Gaul about his son's adventures, we read of a land of dark-skinned woman warriors led by Queen Calafia, who ruled over their island of California. Sound familiar? The Amazon River also gained its name from this legend. As the first European to float down it, Francisco de Orellana was attacked by native women while there, convincing him he had found the land of the Amazons. This pervasive myth also struck the Spanish mainland. Don Martin de Salinas, writing to a secretary of the king in 1533, recounts a silly rumor going around. It appears that the men from his area had heard that a ship carrying 10,000 Amazons had landed in Spain and was offering 15 gold pieces to any man who would mate with them. Don Martin, probably laughing with every pen stroke, reports that men were so convinced that they were about to get paid for sex with exotic Amazons that local prostitutes had to lower prices just to keep up their business. Seems these gullible folks didn't need tall tales in print to fall for every word. As always, remember, history isn't just dates and fanciful fiction. It's the story of you and me, just in different times and different circumstances. One big soap opera, and we should learn it that way. Look around you, find the subscribe button, and mash it. Also, follow me on Instagram, join the conversation on Reddit, and consider becoming a patron at patreon.com. I shall henceforth be known as Peter Parker. My motto shall be, I am Groot.